But brother, I'm assuming you like from here somewhere. Like you didn't need a passport to get here. Where you from? Where you from?
No, I'm from Alaska, Michael Jr.
Yeah, that's what I was saying. Yo, Michael Jr. here, super excited. This is a special episode. And what I mean is, it's really special. And what I mean by special is it's different. And what I mean by different is it's not the same. And what I mean by not the same is it is a solo show. Rarely. In fact, this may be my very first solo show. Now, when I first started doing this podcast, I was in a closet and I decided to do it myself and it was boring and miserable because I was reading a script and I didn't want to do that because I'm such an external processor. I enjoy listening to other people and bouncing back and forth. So that's why I got Pacal and sometimes I have my wife. But what we decided to do on this episode is really just, there's some really amazing thing that, some amazing things that kind of takes place at the live events that people don't know about unless they were at the live event. So I have this thing where I really enjoy improv and I wanted to kind of connect with the audience in a way where it's not just me on stage communicating with them or me sending a joke out, they laugh and I do the next joke, or me telling them something and they respond and I do the next talk. I wanted to do something a little more, so I would start allowing them to ask me questions and I would say, hey, you can ask any question you want to and any question at all, you just have to say Michael Jr. I was wondering. Well, I'm about to share with you some of those really cool, funny, almost magical, if you will, moments that take place live. These are unscripted. This just happens to be what actually happens. So we're about to learn from that. This is called Funny How Life Works, and we're going to use funny to help you understand how life works. But we're doing a little bit of a twist. We're taking some of the live event stuff from either my comedy show or maybe it is from Funny How Marriage Works event. But either way, I think you're going to be pleasantly surprised on how this thing goes down. You might be asking yourself, what could I learn from such a thing? Well, you're about to find out.
Okay.
I love this podcast.
You'll be laughing out loud and all of a sudden, boom, something that can really help you drops in your lap.
I like it because I unexpectedly learn about life.
It is so funny.
I get to laugh and learn about life at the same time.
I like listening to Funny How Life Works with the car of my parents.
With the car in my parents. Okay.
And we're back. So hey, listen, don't forget to leave a review. Don't forget to subscribe. Please leave a review on any platform. Also, we have voicemails. You can leave a voicemail any way and ask any question you want to. You can ask a question about comedy. You can ask about the podcast. You can ask about a certain subject. If you're having some marriage stuff going on and you're a little uncomfortable with it, you can ask Michael Jr. Just say, Michael Jr., I was wondering. And the phone number you would dial for that is 214-308-1177. That is 214-308-1177. Let me say that again. 7711-803-412. That's the same number backwards. Figure it out. Just rewind this thing, play it backwards. Anyway, you know what the number is. So, and we also like to talk about a non-sponsor sponsor. Why do we have non-sponsor sponsors? Well, there's some really great organizations out there. And I'm kind of giving you the behind the scenes. And we really, really appreciate what they're doing. And instead of just waiting for somebody to pay us before we talk about them, I just want to talk about them now. And that someday somebody will pay us for some sponsorship. We haven't really been aggressive about going after that. We just really want to bring this content to the people. And if we get paid at some point for it, that's going to be awesome too. But it'll just be bonus. It's not what's necessary. It's not 100% necessary. And at the end of every episode, we really enjoy giving something away to people. So at the end of this episode, we'll probably give you, maybe I'm guessing, is access to the press-in process. It's a process that can help you better deal with whatever bothers you. Those little pet peeves, it'll help you utilize them in a way so you can grow and be a better human doggone being. So all you do is go to michaeljr.com/press-in and we'll send that to you. I might mention it again at the end of the show. If not, they'll just play this again at the end of the show and then you'll know. You would just cut it and put it at the end, it'd be the same thing. They'll just cut it, we'll put it at the end, it'll be the same thing. They'll just cut it, we'll put it at the end, it'll be, you know what I'm talking about. Boom. So with that being said, let's jump into some Michael Jr. I was wondering. This is the live events. This is some of my favorite moments from live events. I think you'll enjoy them. I'm going to enjoy them as well. And then maybe we'll talk on the back end of this thing. But go ahead and enjoy Michael Jr., I was wondering.
What's your name?
My name is Dale.
Dale, yeah, that's right. You changed your shirt. I met you earlier. You changed your shirt. It's hard to tell. Little kids all look alike. You know what I'm saying? That was weird. All right, what's your question, Dale?
I was going to ask
you. The rules are simple, Dale. It's Michael Jr. I was wondering.
Michael Jr., I wonder. Do you still remember me?
What's that?
Do you still remember me?
Yeah, of course. Man, you got these people thinking you my son or something now, dude. Yeah, we met earlier. This is getting weird. Trust me, I've never seen that kid before in my life. Next question. Any question at all? We got a mic runner over here, too. Any question at all? Cool. There's a young lady right here. What's your name?
Lori.
Hey, Lori. How are you? That's an awesome name. I like the name Lori. Where are you from?
Panama City Beach, Florida.
Oh, yeah. Panama City Beach, Florida. That's down there in Florida.
And the summit, it's their 21st year, and that's my lucky number.
Okay, that's enough. What's your question? I'm just saying.
Michael Jr., I was wondering if we could see you dance tonight.
Oh. Yeah. Not at all. Next question. Next question. Next question.
Okay.
Cool. What's your name?
My name's Bill.
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 Cool. It's a weird name. I'm just playing. I'm just playing. Bills always seem to show up in my life. I don't know if you noticed that.
Mine too.
Like in the mailbox, it's kind of weird. What's your question, Bill?
Michael Jr., I was wondering, how many people would we have to move to the moon in order to affect the tides?
Security? That was awesome. Next question. Next question. We got someone in the back. What's your name?
Russell Christensen. Michael J., I'm
sorry. There's too much going on right now. Michael J. is a rapper. I'm Michael Jr., but go ahead. What's your question?
Michael J., I'm wondering why they call those chicken pieces drumsticks. They don't look anything like that. They look more like prehistoric clubs.
So you think it's cool to ask a black dude about chicken right now? It's a little weird. It's a little weird. What's your name? You can stand up. They're passing them. Oh, snap. It's a brother. What's up, man? Cool.
What's up?
Wait. Before you say anything, I'm going to tell you right now, like, this is a brother, bro. Like, I could tell by what's cracking, because sometimes, especially in this crowd, you don't know where the brother came from. That brother, I'm assuming you, like, from here somewhere. Like, you didn't need a passport to get here. Where are you from?
No, I'm from Alaska, Michael Jr.
Yeah, that's what I was saying. No, for real. Like Alaska?
Like Alaska, Anchorage, Alaska. And yes, there are brothers in Alaska.
I'm going to say not anymore because you left. Yeah,
that's
so
close.
Maybe when you get back. But no, cool. What's your question, bro?
It's an excellent segue. Michael Jr., I was wondering, will you ever make it up to Anchorage, Alaska? We'd love to have you there.
Oh, cool. You know, I actually went to Alaska. There's a city there, and you can verify this. There's a city there called North Pole. For real, is there a city called North Pole? You were born in North Pole, a brother in North Pole. Man, Santa Claus wasn't only getting cookies, was he? One more question, last question, right here. Hey, what's up, bro? I'm gonna go passport on you. I'm just filling passport. Could be wrong. Where you from?
The Dominican Republic.
Yeah. I knew it was a passport involved. I could tell by the way you rose up. What's your name, sir?
Eric.
Eric. I like how you put the K on the end of that, or the C, or whatever it is.
Surprisingly, there's no K at the end of it. It's just E-R-I-C, but it's okay.
What just happened? You pronounce the C or whatever. I've never written you a letter. I don't know how you spell it. I'm just saying, I love how you enunciate the C at the end. That was good, Eric.
Okay.
What part of the Dominican Republic are you from?
The capital, Santo Domingo. Any Dominicans here?
Yeah, I have a friend who got a cousin that went there once. So yeah, it was the Dominican Republic for which
surely
he stands.
We'll have to go again because it's a beautiful country,
one nation,
beautiful island.
Under God, individual. Cool, yeah, I'm gonna have to trust you, man. So, all right, what's your question?
Okay, speaking about countries,
the rules are simple. It's Michael Jr. I was wondering, I don't know how you do it in Dominican Republic. But go ahead.
Michael Jr., I was wondering if you could tell us what is your favorite country in the world aside from your country, the U.S.
Okay, my favorite country in the world. My favorite country. I got some stuff popping up. I'm not gonna say I wanted to. You ever been to Alabama before? Yeah, it's a whole nother country. It's a whole nother country. What we'll do now is we're going to go ahead and take a voicemail, and in a moment, we're going to jump into some Michael Jr. I was wondering. Let's do a voicemail, fellas.
Hi. Based on your current automobile registration, we noticed your automobile might be out of warranty, which protects you against expensive repair bills. Yeah. Don't be caught off guard by the high cost of parts and labor. Hit the number 7 on your phone right now to have coverage reinstated.
So, that was a very important voicemail. I appreciate you so much. It's awesome how the fans are so concerned about the things. They just want me to have the best life possible. And the fact that I don't have the insurance against my car, just great. Thank you for being there in such a way. And thank you for not sounding like a computer. Thank you for that. I do. Let's listen to another voicemail.
Hi, my name is Kalisha Snoddy. I'm from Oklahoma.
Oklahoma.
Michael Jr., I was wondering, do you have the Bible secretly memorized? Like the whole Bible. I was just wondering if you did, and I have a suspicion that you do, what is Psalm 86:11?
Ooh, wow. How
That's
did
my
she...
question. Also, okay. This is There's my first time leaving a voicemail, so can I please get that free access code to the Funny How Life Works course? Thank you.
Okay, she's done. So there's a two-parter. What is, first of all, on Psalms 86:11, oh my goodness, that's so easy. It's a psalm. And then did she say Psalms or Proverbs? She must say Psalms 86:11. Let me see if I could think about what that is. I feel like it's like what would I say that is? It's like, teach me your way, O Lord, that I may walk in your truth. Unite my heart to fear your name. I think that's it, right? That's what Google said, because I'm looking at it on the screen. Yeah. So I think that's what it says. So thank you for assuming I had the whole Bible memorized, like I was Denzel Washington and I was blind. If you don't know what that means, then you got to watch the movie. So, and then the second part of your question, can you get the code to the course? Yeah, you can get the code. Absolutely. When you put your credit card number in, the code will show up in your email and you can get the code to the Funny How Life Works course. Thank you for asking. The Bible also says if you ask, you can receive. And if you don't, then you won't. So what I want you to do is I want you to go ahead and email ari@michaeljr.com. Tell her your name, tell her your information, and we'll probably send you a code because I just feel like we should. And you better watch it and enjoy it with your family. Boom. All right. So with that being said, what we're going to do now is we're going to go ahead and jump into, we're going to do it. We're going to jump into Michael Jr., I Was Wondering. Check these clips. Boom.
I'm going to go right there, that guy right there with the yes, you, sir. What's your name?
My name's Doug from Crystal Falls,
Doug.
Michigan.
Doug, like the past tense of dig?
I'm not sure how to answer that.
Just say yes.
Yes.
Cool. How long you been married?
I've been married 14 years.
Cool. Why does it sound like there's a question mark on the internet? I've been married 14 years? That is awesome. What's your question? How many kids do you have?
I got 2 kids.
2 kids. Which one do you like the best?
I like them both the same.
Yeah. You don't want to say, but you did have a vision of one of them pop up in your head. You had a vision pop up. One of them popped up. It was. It's okay. You don't have to say. And what's your question?
Michael Jr., I was wondering what your feeling is on spankings.
I'm a grown man. I don't get them no more, bro. What is my feelings on spankings? I actually think it's a good thing. On the real, I mean, that was the joke part. But on the real, I think it should happen. I think it should be very strategic, though. I think it should only be up to like a certain age, like right around 19. You gotta stop that stuff. Gotta turn and hit him in the jaw after that. I'm just playing. That's probably not right. All right, cool. So, what's your question,
Michael Jr.? I was just wondering why parents do not allow their boys to be boys.
Like when you say boys to be boys, what do you mean?
Yeah, I mean, I watch too many people trying to control their boys and not let them, you know.
How many kids you got? You got kids?
Yes, sir.
Cool.
Six kids, five boys, one girl.
Oh, well, you don't have a choice to let your boy. Your boy's got to be boys. You got one girl.
That's correct.
So here's what's going on. Most people only have one or two. You have five. You have lost a battle. And and now you're saying, why come everybody can't lose the battle? Just let them do whatever they want to do. All I do here is pay the bills. That's what happens, sir. I just need you to come back to reality and recognize I got one son. I can control him pretty well. So you just lost the battle. That's all I want to say about that. So I do think it's important that boys get to fall down and break. Like my wife walked in and my son had a WD-40 can? Remember that? He was pointing it at himself. And he's about to spray it. And my wife walked by. She just happened to be walking past. And she came back. She's like, what are you doing? He's like, I just want to see what's going to happen. That's a boy being a boy. Your problem is there's five fingers and five cans. And you can't stop them off. You're like, whatever, here, take a match. like whatever. So.
All right, as always, I like to go off the cuff. And the off-the-cuff moment I want to go off-the-cuff on is when the young lady from the voicemail called and she asked if she can get a course for free. A course for free. You tripping, right? Which would have been a knee-jerk response. But instead of just saying she was tripping, I actually took a moment, I paused and said, I wonder if I should or not. See, I have this thing that I do. Me and my wife, we do this and we teach this to our kids. Where we really love doing whatever we feel like God is telling us to do, regardless to what the situation looks like. So an example that I'll give is, I'll just stick with that example. You would think if somebody asked for that, I would say no, but the Bible actually says you have not because you ask not. So the fact that she asked, I was able to ask God if I should, and I actually gave. God is very similar to that sometimes. Sometimes all you need to do is ask. Or maybe it's not even as spiritual as that. Maybe you have a friend that has something you need and you just need to ask. Maybe you have the mindset of I shouldn't ask because I don't deserve. Maybe you have that mindset and you're not even aware of it. So what I would challenge you to do is to ask the question, are you afraid to ask the question? Meaning, are you afraid to ask for something that you need and your real fear is feeling rejection at the end of it? Maybe there won't even be any rejection there for you, or maybe the real key is for you to deal with the predetermined access to you feeling rejected. Either way, there's something in there if you have a hard time asking for something that you need or that you feel like you want to add to your life. So by all means, ask. It's okay. You may even open up the door so somebody else could ask of you. I love you. I appreciate you. I'm Michael Jr. It's funny how life works. Boom. That was dope. It was cool. Funny how life works. Got a giveaway. Don't forget. Go to michaeljr.com/press in. michaeljr.com/press in. It's going to be dope. So now I'm going to spin the wheel because we don't got a guess. So I guess a brother going to spin the wheel. Bling. Spinning the wheel. Wheel is spinning. And the question is, if you could instantly become an expert in a foreign language, what would it be? I'd want to know what people talk about when they're speaking in tongues. No, I would say a foreign language. Wow, I would want to speak female. I would really enjoy being able to speak female. Not like I talk it, but just that I could better understand it. Because sometimes, not my wife doesn't do this, but some women want you to be able to anticipate what they're thinking beforehand, and I'd love to just be able to speak that. That would be awesome, because I could interpret. It would be all kind of dudes lined up spinning money, giving me a whole bunch of money so I could tell them what their wife talking about. All right. She said, take the garbage out, but she don't want to have to tell you. She says she's thirsty, but she don't want you to know. She said that she wants you to figure out what restaurant to go to. That's why she said, I don't know. Like, I would clean up. That'd be awesome. That'd be dope. Yo, appreciate you guys. You are completely awesome. Go make your life and somebody else's amazing. And the way to make your life amazing is by helping somebody else make theirs that way. I love you. I'm out. Go to michaeljr.com/press in, and we'll send that to you. I might mention it again at the end of the show. If not, they'll just play this again at the end of the show, and then you'll know. You'll just cut it and put it at the end, it'll be the same thing. They'll just cut it, we'll put it at the end, it'll be the same thing. They'll just cut it, we'll put it at the end, it'll be, you know what I'm talking about.